Hello, Warlords of the Coast, and welcome to a very quiet episode. Oh, wait a minute. No, it really is that quiet. Due to a few technical difficulties, we seem to be having no sound on our League of Legends replays. Now, I have checked things. I have checked the headphones are plugged in. I have checked that other things play sound through the headphones. I have checked other League of Legends replays, and other League of Legends replays play perfectly with sound and everything. This one replay, the first of our 1v1 tournament for this month, has no sound, and there's nothing I can do about it. That being said, I'll probably introduce a little bit of a music track to the whole event. Hope you don't mind it too much. It'll mean that I don't have to talk constantly just to make noise through the entire 21 minutes of gameplay. Here we're watching the first knockout of the tournament between Tompo playing as Corki. And he's gone for Ninja Tab and Doran's Blade to get started. And already after the first exchange, it seems like BJ, who's playing Sion, has gone for Boots, Lifesteal and a Doran's Blade. And several pots to get down there as well. Of course, Sion would have the advantage in the early game, having more health, slightly more armor no doubt, and a bit more attack, but Corki should soon get the edge. So let's see how the game progresses. BJ with the normal opening attack of the stun, making sure to keep the opponent off guard so he can get a couple of good hits in before anything happens. And Corki, of course, opening up with the big Gatling gun effect. Let's see now. The Gatling gun. 4 seconds, dealing 44 plus 10 physical damage and reducing 6 armor per second. So that's reducing his 40 armor down to virtually nothing. And then hitting him with everything else he's got. But it still doesn't seem to be enough. Corki still takes more damage than he can deal at this stage in the game, even though they're both level 6. Sion's ulti, as we should know, heals him with a 50% lifesteal and 50% attack speed for 20 seconds. Also heals his allies, but that doesn't make any difference in a 1v1. Corki getting his Gatling gun out constantly. It's a good form of attack. It's a good start. And he's taking him down, even with his ulti on, he's taking him down. First blood. So let's see, level 9 Corki dealing 101 damage. Now Sion comes back out with 212 damage on his basic attacks. Double the damage, but none of the range. So if Tompo can keep him at bay, we should see another very close contest in lane. And Cook. I was about to say something, but it never happened. In goes the ulti. There goes the regen. Lifesteal, lifesteal, lifesteal. And more lifesteal. Tops him straight back up again. Very good champion for the lane. However, he's 1-0 down at the minute. And looking like he might take another one. Corki having to use an epic leap out the way. But still, he's got the range advantage. Toppo concentrating on the minions. Occasional long-range poke. And 1 second, Sion's ulti coming back on again. Will he use it on the next minion wave? Get in there? Yes, he will. Of course he will. Gets all his health back in a matter of moments. As Corki has to go flying off. Quick snatch of the health pot BJ had there, just to make sure that Tompo didn't have it available to him for another few seconds. Gatling gun effect, shield on. Not reducing the mighty Sion much at all. Grabbing the health as soon as it came available again. Ripping the minion waves to pieces with the Gatling gun. Now BJ has had a chance to go back to the shop. He's bought a BF sword. As Corki's still working on his starting items, still maintaining the lane. Just a constant barrage. Attack after attack. Now it's Corki that's back on full health, dealing a lot of damage out. It's only 119 per basic attack, but his abilities are churning out the damage faster than Sion can heal up. BJ seems to be concentrating on last hitting the minions. And he's taking lots of hits again. Will his health regen manage? Yeah, his health regen just too much for Corki to deal with. And a stun and a steal. Some more Gatling gun to get rid of the minions. Turret is safe again. Sion's ulti only has a minute and a half cooldown. It's quite a big bonus for BJ here. He's got it online again. No reason to use it just yet. Another minion wave coming. Will he use it in this next minion wave to clear it out quickly? Still doesn't have a need. Should probably get himself into the combat. Stuck in and then activate. Indeed he does, activate the ulti. Back up to full. Oh, he has to run away again. Seems to be a pattern forming. Turret goes down. Now Corki doesn't have quite so much to hide behind. Sion up to 255 basic attack damage right now. advantage is on Sion's side again, with the ulti kicking off after the minute and a half cooldown. Another turret taking lots of damage. Corki chasing him down. All the minions and Corki are no match for Sion. He's only 30 seconds away from getting all of his health back and dealing out that 260 damage with a Doran's Blade and a Scepter. He's getting his health back almost as quickly. The ult is on and he's down. Well, made a big difference staying out in lane for so long. Tompo managing to buy an awful lot of items that deal quite a lot of damage now. Up to 218 damage himself with his abilities. Keep churning out a lot more, his movement speed nice and fast. His armor penetration. Sion coming back out with just a hell of a lot more damage and lifesteal. 400 damage. Doing 1,000 critical, I saw there. Off goes Sion's ulti again. Tompo's got a long way to run. Oh, he went back for it, and the stun caught him out, but just managing to get away with a shield on. Really got to be careful, he's going to die. Yes. Oh, crash and burn, it seems. And now Sion, just forget the minions and just hit, yeah, job done. Surrender. A surrender? It's possibly the first surrender we've seen in the tournament so far. In fact, I think it is the first surrender we've seen. Corki just no match for the sheer brute force and ignorance of Sion. Till next time, folks.